Imagine this. Anybody in this room, if I could say, hey, somebody cured AIDS, y'all be like, yeah, right.
Every part of life is being man-made. And the reason why is because you can't patent nature. You can patent anything you make man-made. When you make it patent, now I can make money. When I have a seed, I can take that seed and put it in the ground, make a tree. I can take the seeds from the fruit, save them from the next generation, and say, hey, when you go grow your land, I already have seeds for you. Seeds will last that long. The more and more you see like seeds missing from things, like this, bananas have seeds in them. Pineapples have seeds in them. So many things supposed to have seeds, but you never see seeds in them anymore.
He said to me, what am I going to eat? I said, drink penny carrot juice, drink beet juice, drink celery juice. And the woman said, stop. I said, why, man? Or the book says that garlic is a food, and so is the celery, carrots. You mix them together. She said, son, those things are made. I said, what, man? Made by who? It come out of the ground, man. God made everything that come out of the ground. No, son. I said, but man, said, that's what the book says. That's what Miss Holloman is telling me. That's what the book says. God ain't saying that. And that's true. And guess what I found? That everything you find in the supermarket was made. They have 666 varieties of apple. They have 32 varieties of cucumber. Rice, they have about 25 varieties of rice.
Do you know the apples that you get at the store are actually man-made? This apple is definitely going to taste more tart, and it's going to be equivalent to a lot of people like to call them crab apples, but that's exactly the sign of a God-made apple. The next thing that you're going to look for is this natural substance that is on an apple that's not treated with chemicals, pesticides, or herbicides, and you're gonna make sure that it's nice and shiny.
Cancer loves sugar. The fact is that a cancer cell consumes 15 times the glucose of any other cell.
Yes, the bankers hijack our food basket. So let them call it veganism, let them call it keto for vegans or whatever.
Now restaurants are featuring everything from Impossible Burgers to Beyond Sausage breakfast sandwiches on their menu.
Pretty good.
It's very tender, juicy.
But is plant-based meat really healthier for you?
I've never had plant taste like beef before.
It's like a beef burger.
I don't associate.
With a patty made from plants, no beef.
No beef.
Made from plants.
I don't associate.
Ever paused mid-bite to ponder the origins of your food? Consider this. What if I told you that the salad you're enjoying might have more in common with a science project than a simple plant? Is there a big difference between food products and actual food? Asked, Dr. Aris, the 76-year-old originator of Sun-Fired Cuisine, who boasts of not being sick in over 50 years.
So after 53 years of not consuming animal and being known as a vegetarian, I know that modern food has been weaponized. And that's why I had to even get out, yes, of the cosmopolitan way of living, the metropolitan way of living, the urban way of living, the big city life. And I'm back in my element. I'm in nature. I'm in the rainforest.
He firmly believes in consuming food naturally grown from the earth and baked with natural sunlight.
Forget plant-based and all of those other levels. Let's take it back to the sun. The sun is the master chef. We're just little artists down here putting the sun's work together so that it can be associated with what is today accepted as modern cuisine art.
His commitment to the raw food diet has spanned over 53 years. As the world tilts towards futuristic feasts, here's the scoop. Scientists have ditched the farm for the lab, cultivating meat that skips the pasture and goes straight to your plate. No moo, no oink, or cluck. Just pure science. Don't believe me? Listen to Dr. Bobby Price, a former pharmacist, now a farmer and author, who travels the world sharing the magical art of healing the mind, body, and soul, and helping individuals regain their well-being through plant-based meals, herbal medication, and holistic practices.
So many things supposed to have seeds, but you never see seeds in them anymore. So pretty much at some point, all food is going to be man-made.
Ready to try a burger that's never grazed in a field? If you think that's all, here are some lab-grown foods that might just be the future stars of your favorite restaurants and catering gigs. Lab-grown nightmares. In the dimly lit corridors of 2013, Mosa Meat unveiled a chilling innovation with a creation not forged by nature, but by cold, unfeeling machinery. A clean hamburger costing $325,000. This monstrosity heralded a future where such creations would become commonplace and affordable, and dominated dinner tables worldwide since 2021. Simultaneously, Just Laboratories conjured the phantom of opulent Wagyu beef, offering a ghostly incarnation of marbled Japanese delicacies to those daring enough to indulge, while their plant-based cookie dough tempted with sinful delight. Not far behind, Perfect Day's dairy-free cream cheese, crafted from lab-grown wonders, threatened to bewitch bagels everywhere without any bovine intervention. Meanwhile, Clara Foods brewed a potion of cultured eggs, planning to enchant vegans and omnivores alike with their ethereal eggs. In the tech-cursed kitchens of Memphis Meats, haunted meatballs and other meats simmered, promising a terrifying, delicious future as they prepare to invade markets as of 2021. Could the future of dining be unfolding before our eyes? Select U.S. restaurants have started serving laboratory-grown chicken, creating a frenzy as diners line up, eager for a taste of this futuristic fare. From the time the U.S. Department of Agriculture granted final approval, a few trailblazing California companies have begun to sell lab-produced chicken nationwide. But what exactly does this mean for your dinner plate? While widespread availability in grocery stores may still be a few years away, but an intriguing battle is brewing over how this new kind of meat is presented and sold. Several states, spurred by traditional meat industries, are already tightening the rules around what can and cannot be labeled as meat.
Processed meats are on the same list with cigarettes. They're that cancerous. Like, our food really is killing us. But that's just also why we're seeing so many young children with high cholesterol, diabetes, getting cancer. You didn't see that before.
Processed meat. Diving into the world of processed meat is like stepping into a culinary soap opera. Hidden within those seemingly innocent slices of deli meats are a cast of chemical compounds that wouldn't normally mingle with fresh meat. These characters are not only dramatic, but can also be a tad nefarious when it comes to your health. Sealed within their shiny packages lies a risk comparable to some of the most notorious hazards known to humanity.
Processed meats like bacon, breakfast sausages, deli meats like turkey meat, bologna, ham, etc. These processed smoked meats, all of these meats, these processed meats, unfortunately, are laced with these salts that are called sodium nitrate, okay, and nitrates. These sodium nitrate compounds are carcinogenic. As a matter of fact, the governing body, as I mentioned before, that is the IARC, that determines what is carcinogenic, what causes cancer, has put processed meats, the same one we make these sandwiches for our kids, we're making for ourselves for lunch. They have put these meats in the same category with cigarettes, asbestos, and plutonium. So as a result, these meats are banned outside of the U.S.
According to The Guardian, the World Health Organization has sounded the alarm, elevating processed meats to the infamous list of Group 1 carcinogens. This list chillingly includes asbestos, alcohol, arsenic, and tobacco, substances that pose serious health risks. Step away from the allure of convenience and consider the ominous implications of these everyday items on your plate. Amidst these innovations, a revelation came to light about fruits and veggies. Some of the most natural snacks might just be Mother Nature's clever imposters, revealing a world where man-made munchies could shock the unsuspecting palate. Now, just because a snack screams vegan, gluten-free, or sugar-free doesn't mean it's your ticket to better health. What's really lurking under those virtuous labels? Could it be junk food in disguise, masquerading labels that sound wholesome? Consider this. When manufacturers strip away fat to proudly slap on a fat-free label, what gets pumped back in to keep our taste buds happy? Often, it's sugar, loads of it.
Coke Zero is a healthier alternative or option, okay? They won't mention to you that, you know, the sugar itself that is using Coke Zero that is no calories is actually a neurotoxin, okay? Never mention that.
And we need to know what cancer loves so we can stop it. Cancer loves sugar. The fact is that a cancer cell consumes 15 times the glucose of any other cell.
Artificial sugars, a deep deception, marketed as a beacon of health. Artificial sugars are, in reality, nothing more than a concoction of chemicals that bewilder our bodies. So detrimental are these substances that numerous countries have outright banned them. Contrary with helping with weight loss, research suggests that these synthetic sweeteners calories may in fact be paving the way to weight gain. It's a deceptive marketing miracle where the promise of health is overshadowed by potential harm. Fruit juice, a masked villain? It's a common misconception that because fruit is healthy, fruit juice must be too. However, the truth about fruit juice is far more complex and less wholesome. Many products labeled as fruit juice don't actually contain any real fruit, but are concocted from chemicals mimicking fruit flavors and heavily laced with sugar. When fruit is transformed into juice, its essential fibers are stripped away, leaving a liquid that's brimming with sugar. It's a fruit facade that loses the essence of what makes fruit beneficial. Opting for whole fruits instead of their juiced counterparts isn't just a better choice, it's the best one. Sports drinks, necessary or not. Sports drinks are often seen as the ultimate hydration solution, especially with their blend of electrolytes and sugars meant to restore what's lost in sweat during intense physical activity. However, for the average person, these brightly colored beverages are more about excess than necessity. Unless you're a marathon runner or engaging in extreme sports, the additional salts and sugars can do more harm than good. For those seeking true hydration, water remains the unmatched champion. Purdue University reveals a jaw-dropping fact. Nearly half of all Americans, and the world by extension, are at risk of developing high blood pressure, also known as hypertension. But what happens when hypertension goes unchecked? It's a chilling path that leads directly to strokes, kidney failure, heart attacks, and even heart failure. And heart attacks? They're not just a leading cause of death. They're mostly the direct result of diets heavy with fatty deposits that clog and narrow our arteries. Why are these diseases haunting us? The answer may shock you. We weren't meant to die in such numbers from heart disease, heart attacks, strokes, diabetes, and cancers of the lungs, breast, prostate, and colon, experts say. History shows that significant heart disease only spiked with diets rich in animal products and the rise of highly processed foods packed with calories but stripped of nutrition. How did our nourishment become our nemesis? What can we do to reclaim our health? Unveiling Nature's Bounty, a guide to God-made foods. In a world brimming with health hazards, the key to warding off disease could be closer than you think, within the bounty that God, or as some might say, nature, has laid before us.
Iron has been omitted from our diet for 500 years. When all of you that came to see me, I would recommend that you take 2 tablespoons 3 times a day. And even the 2 tablespoons 3 times a day, you feel, hey, I'm back alive. I'm only giving you that which is going to be consuming that day.
He said, when people come to me with high blood pressure, I put them on Celtic salt. Because Celtic salt contains 82 minerals. It contains magnesium chloride, magnesium bromide, and magnesium sulfate. And because magnesium is a water-hungry molecule, it can be used to help the water get into the cell. So when you take a crystal of Celtic salt, put it on your tongue, your mucous membranes start absorbing the minerals, the magnesium is taken to the cell membrane and you drink your water, and that magnesium pulls that water inside the cell. It's the quickest way to hydrate a body. The only time excess water drinking can be dangerous is if people drink too much at once and don't have the minerals that are in the Celtic salt to pull that water inside the cell.
Embracing this pristine, unaltered gifts in our diets not only promises a healthier life, but could be our safeguard against many illnesses. Beware the wolf in sheep's clothing. Many foods marketed as healthy are nothing but clever disguises by manufacturers.
When you go to the market now, it'll say plant-based, but I read labels. When I turn it on the back and look at the label, I'm like, half of that ain't plants. How can this be plant-based? The trickery that they put in the system now, how they doubled up foods and convinced us that we're eating healthy, but we're not eating healthy.
These man-made imposters often masquerade as nutritious, but may in fact be far from it. It takes wisdom and a strong resolve to identify and choose the pure, wholesome foods intended for our well-being. As God said, "Behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed, which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree, in the which is the fruit of a tree yielding seed. To you it shall be for meat." Genesis 1:29.